Hi, everyone, and welcome to another edition of City Spotlight. I'm your host, Pablo Pereira. Well, it's no secret that Calabasas has one of the best public libraries anywhere in Southern California. But you know, a great library is not only what's found in its books, but often the artwork displayed inside. And right now, inside the Calabasas Library, they're creating a beautiful new mural. Let's go inside and check it out.
Ricardo Alvarez, and I was always trying to get into movies until I was 21. That's when I started getting more into working for the Disney animation, feature animation, as a background painter for animation. And I got a lot of training here, and mainly for movies.
All right, we're here with the man of the hour. He's the artist Ricardo Alvarez, and we are in the children's reading room here inside the library. And before we begin, you wanted to show me, because we were talking a little bit in advance, of how hard it is to paint a mural on a ceiling. And we're gonna do a little demonstration here, right? Because
yeah.
You say it's pretty difficult, right?
Well, it's difficult, not for me right now, because I already got the training.
So what am I gonna try to do here?
Well, you need to actually, I have a little brush that you can try. Let me just put some in. And the idea is that you need to hold it and try to make a straight line, or even your name.
My name?
Yeah.
Let's try the straight line first. Okay, that's not very straight. Let's try my name. Okay.
If you can feel now that the gravity is pushing your hand
down. Yeah, it's already getting.
And also your mind is start getting really focused and you get really tired.
I mean, how long have you been painting?
Since I was 2 years old, I've been painting. Yeah, I've been painting on the walls, on books, on different things. You know, whatever I was having in my hands, I was just making drawings. Even at the school, I was not be able to focus very much on the school because I was always painting, doing drawings.
All right, we're here with Ellen Pangarliota. She is on the Library Commission here in the city of Calabasas. And talk to me a little bit about how this all evolved.
Well, I don't know whether you want to go back to the beginning when the Seminole City Council decided that we needed art in public places.
I'm going to entertain a motion at this time regarding direction to the Library Commission.
Can we move on this concept?
Directing the Library Commission.
I'll second that motion.
All those in favor?
Aye.
5-0. Move on to item 5, which is a recommendation from the Library Commission to approve the selection of artist Ricky Alvarez.
Well, the committee was unanimous, and to the extent that the people who entered comment cards gave their statements as to which artists they would like to see.
And you had, I believe, 11 submissions initially.
Did. Yes.
And then what happened?
Well, the 11 submissions included people from as far away as Long Beach, which of course is not that far away. We had recommendations from LACMA. We had people who were local who heard about it and wanted to participate. And we had a committee here, which included Jill Nevins, one of our children's librarians, and I'm sure you'll speak with her later. And it included the members of the Art and Public Places Committee, who are Loreen Morick, Karen Foley, and Martha Fritz, and another library commissioner, Bob Hill, and myself.
All right, we're with Jill Nevins, the children's library specialist. You have to be pretty excited about what's going on in this room here.
I am thrilled. This has been something that I've kind of visualized since I first saw the building and first saw the space, so I'm very excited.
And as we look up at it, the room is called the
Children's Reading Room.
And
I do weekly story times in there. So it'll be really wonderful to have the addition of this beautiful mural for kids to really kind of feel more engaged in what they're reading and the world of imagination.
When does the work begin and when will it end?
First of all, it depends on how the council votes. And at that point, we can go to contract with the artist. And then it's a matter of when the artist would have time to do it. It's our feeling, but we don't know how the council would feel about this.
Well, you probably know I'm very excited about this. I think it's just a fantastic project. This kind of art, as Ellen called it for many, many years, the wow factor in the children's library. And this particular mural of exploration is frankly beyond my expectations for the kind of thing that we would have in our library for the kids to see. And the idea is so creative to have the undersea, the land, and space.
Looks great, and at this time I'd ask for a motion.
I would like to move to approve the Library Commission's recommendation of the selection of the artist Ricky Alvarez.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
5-0. Thank you.
Some of the things in here, some of the concepts.
Okay, so on the recessed ceiling, we have the clouds as they would be in the sky. Over here, we have our red-tailed hawk, and over here, a hot air balloon. But if you look up into the dome, the artist has taken the blue of the recessed ceiling and gotten it darker, 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 till it's the darkest night. You can see the shuttle and the astronaut, and you can see the moon and its craters. So that's quite amazing just to look at that. And as you come around, of course, it's not going to be clear because it's covered with plastic because the sea has just been painted blue and all the mammals of the sea will be in there. But over here next to one of the trees, there's a pumpkin wagon. And over here next to the multicolored paint samples, we have the library and City Hall.
Now you said you had temporarily been doing the reading time out here, and you had an interesting experience this week.
Yes, it was wonderful. Each week there's a topic that I have, and this past week was art and artists and creating art. And so we read the stories out here, and then we walked in and we saw Ricky on his ladder, and the kids just were amazed and looking up at the ceiling, and they were just so excited. And to hear them, you know, wow, and Ricky enjoyed it. I said, this is why we do this. This is what you're doing.
So it can trigger something in a young person's mind too. It's not just a visual, but maybe it triggers thoughts of what they want to do one day.
And exactly.
Maybe it's not just about creativity, but it triggers something. It's like, I want to be like Ricky one day.
Exactly. I want to be like Ricky. I want to be like the astronaut. I want to be like the scuba diver. There's so much to see in the world.
Welcome everyone to the Calabasas Library. I'm Barbara Lockwood and this is Jill Nevins. We're staff at the Calabasas Library. And I'd like to introduce you to our mayor, James Bazajian.
Thank you, Barbara. We're here today to dedicate this beautiful mural all around us that one person has been working on, who we commissioned to paint. What I want to do now is hand over the microphone to Fred Gaines, and he is going to tell us a little bit about the history of how this mural and devising the idea for it and picking out the particular theme came about. Fred?
Well, first of all, it's just so wonderful to see everyone in this room, the kids and the parents. This is exactly what we dreamed of when we thought about having our library and our children's library and then creating this very special room, the pod or the egg that we called it. What we weren't sure exactly what we were gonna do with it, but we were hoping it would be a place for you to do exactly what you're doing today, to bring the kids to for reading, for music, for special programs. And once it was built, we said, what can we do to really add a wow factor? And our arts in public places, we have an arts fee that we had never spent before, and we put our arts committee together. They went out and commissioned several artists. Was it six? Six different artists to come up with different ideas. Those ideas went out to the public. We had them here in the library. We had them on our website, on CTV. People voted. And then our arts committee and our library commission, ultimately our city council, chose Ricky Alvarez to come in and do this incredible mural called Exploration. And it takes us, of course, from the sea to the land to the sky to space, and includes some very, very special things, including the red-tailed hawk, which is this symbol of our city, our city hall, so you can see exactly where you are, our city hall and library, while you sit here. The pumpkin cart, the history of Calabasas, why are we named Calabasas? Because of the crashing of the pumpkin cart, and the pumpkins growing wild in this area, and so we have the pumpkin cart, and then of course all the way up into space, and our space person up there. We don't know if that's a man or woman inside that spacesuit, but that's our, it's a woman, okay. The artist says it's a woman, okay, so. But we hope it's a place that both the parents and especially the kids will come and find something interesting to see and dream about and enhance their experience here in the library. But we're just so pleased with how it's turned out and that you're all here today. And so this time I'm going to turn it back to the mayor to make the presentation.
And before I do that, I want to just give you a little couple sentences about the history of the library. You know, as a smaller city, when we first started out, we contracted with the county for library services. And your tax dollars went into a county pool, and then we get certain services from the county. And when we studied that, we discovered that for every dollar that you were being taxed, about half of it would go downtown into this general overhead that we never really saw. So we did a study, and we decided that it would be better and more cost-effective and provide more services to have our own library. We seceded from the county system and established the Calabasas Municipal Library in 1999. And it's been a wonderful success. All of your tax dollars now come straight here to provide for materials, staffing, and services. We have a library commission. Commissioners Bob Hill and Jennifer Owry were unable to be here today, but they work very hard in making sure you get the maximum level of services. I'd also be remiss in not mentioning that in founding the library, there were a few people who were really instrumental in helping out and have stayed with the library from day one and have really been the key to making this a great success. And one of those is Ellen Pangar Leotis. She hasn't really gotten a lot of recognition for it. But sometimes I feel when someone volunteers and goes the extra mile for something like that, they do deserve some recognition. So I hope you're very proud of everything you've worked for, Ellen, starting with the committee that discussed founding the library. The state of California should also be thanked. They gave us a grant for $8.2 million to build this library out of state proposition funds that are, of course, not so common anymore. But we got the money, and we were able to build this library because of it. Now, without further ado, I am going to turn to Ricardo Alvarez, who is the artist, and he's going to give us some words about his work. And I'm going to present him with a certificate first, which says, the Calabasas City Council does hereby recognize Ricardo Alvarez for his splendid design and artistry in painting the mural Exploration in the Calabasas Library Children's Reading Room, March 18th, 2012. And it's signed by all the council members. So here's your certificate that you can display. And I want to take a moment to give to you as part of the program, to tell us a little bit about your work and how you did it and the time it took. It looks like it took a lot of time. And just tell you about your experiences in painting it.
Okay. Well, first of all, it's been an honor for me just to please everyone, because this is not exactly something that I was thinking. For me, I was thinking about the kids. And when I came here, I saw the structure of the building. And the design was like meant to be like that. I saw the ocean and the sky, and everything was kind of like in layers, ready to go. So the idea was ready. It's just, it needed just the artist to do it. And with your help, you know, of course, I came up with more things that I put together about the history of Calabasas. And all your ideas, they just complement my vision when I came here. But somehow it was already meant to be like that. I don't know if it was a coincidence, but it was just ready to go. The mural looks like this because the building was designed like that. So it's, yeah, that's all I can.
How long did it take you?
It took me about a month to do it. And of course, you know, I was just taking a little bit more of the normal time because I wanted to be nice. And sometimes I was just redoing things and making it work the right way. Even the blue, it took me a little while just to figure out which is the main color all over the place. And when you put the first color, that's going to dictate the other ones. So I have to be very careful with the first one.
Well, let's ask you on, do you like this painting? I mean, do you think it's... Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, ready? One, two, three. There we go. So now you'll be remembered for time immemorial. And with that, we're adjourned.
Well, that's going to do it for this edition of City Spotlight. We hope you've enjoyed the program. More importantly, next time you pay a visit here to the local library, don't forget to check out the children's reading room and the city's brand new mural. It really is quite a fascinating sight. I'm Pablo Pereira. Thanks for joining us.